Beginning with that college tour tragedy in Orland, a horrific collision that investigators say could take months to sort out. Here is what we do know at this hour. 10 people were killed, 31 hurt, 7 of those are still in critical condition. And the investigation into how it happened is just beginning. For the very latest, here's Action News reporter Mike Tissell from our Hearst sister station, KCRA, in Orland.
It happened just after 5:30 Thursday evening. This bus filled with prospective students was on its way for a visit to Humboldt State University when the driver of a FedEx tractor trailer crossed the median, hitting the bus head on.
Upon our arrival, it was already fully engulfed in flames.
Someone inside the bus busted a window, allowing many of the passengers to escape. 31 people were taken to 7 hospitals. Officials say 9 were dead at the scene. A 10th died in the hospital from severe burns.
It's a humongous tragedy and a tragic event of a magnitude that's not typical for this county.
To see young people get hurt, or in this case some of them were actually killed, that's a real tragedy, and we wanted to come and do everything we could to help the young people that had survived.
Parents from across the state rushed to Orland, where many of the students were taken, including this woman, who made the drive all the way from Orange County with her family. She says she couldn't walk fast enough to reunite with her daughter, who survived the crash.
I'm very excited I'm here because I came from Orange County, so I'm very excited for waiting to see her.
More than 12 hours after the crash, the debris is finally being towed from Interstate 5, but investigators are still looking for what may have happened to cause the semi driver to cross the road.
We don't know whether the FedEx driver had fallen asleep, whether he experienced a mechanical failure with his vehicle, or whether there was a separate collision on the southbound side that caused him to lose control.
Parents like this one just happy to be lucky enough to be reunited with their children.
Oh, giving thanks to God because my daughter's alive.
The majority of the survivors have now been reunited with their parents, though answers in this crash may be a long time coming, as investigators say determining a cause could take months. In Orland, California, I'm Mike Tissell.
And continuing our coverage of the I-5 crash, no surprise, this tragedy has cast a light on what's being done to address safety standards on large buses and how to make it easier for passengers to get out in the case of an accident. In 1999, the National Transportation Safety Board recommended that federal regulators issue new standards for large buses. And the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration has been working on bus evacuation regulations since 2007, but has not yet offered a proposal.